Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics. This lecture is entitled Analog to Digital Conversion Methods, Successive Approximation. Okay, so our previous discussions of flash conversion were its major advantages. It's fast, it's simple, disadvantage a lot of hardware. And then we went to our dual slope conversion, where the disadvantage is it takes a little bit of time and got some math involved into it, you know, the proportionality of time to that of the voltage. And the advantage is the fact that it doesn't use a lot of hardware. Successive approximation is kind of the middle of the road in between them. It's not as fast as flash, but it is faster than dual slope. It uses a little bit of hardware, but not as much as a flash conversion method. One of the major advantages about successive approximation, it takes a constant amount of time. Whereas a dual slope, you know, you've got some variable amounts of time to deal with that. Additionally, the successive approximation, for us to make this thing work, we're actually going to use a DAC, so a digital to analog converter, to make an ADC. And what's cool about this, you don't need to know how a digital to analog converter works right now. You don't need to know the internal workings. You just need to understand that if I put digital input into that digital to analog converter, analog voltage will come out. What I've got here is in the upper right-hand corner here in our block diagram is a digital to analog conversion. This is my input. That's my digital input. Here's my analog voltage output. And let's say that this thing goes from 0 to 15 volts. And what I will say is when I put in quadruple ones, I want 15 volts out. When I put in 0, 1, 0, 0, I want 4 volts out, so on and so forth. So it's just a very simple rendition. Like ADC, DAC, bunch of different styles of doing that. We'll go into how those things work in a little bit. And what successive approximation is, it's making use of a digital to analog converter and what's known as a successive approximation register. And that's what this thing is below here. SAR, successive approximation register. It's kind of like the registers that we've discussed thus far, but the only thing that's different between this, it goes from MSB down to LSB and just kind of walks through every single one of those bit positions, hence a constant time for this thing to occur. And this is kind of like one of those bracketing things. It's like playing a guessing game with a four-year-old. You're like, okay, what letter am I thinking of? And the four-year-old's like, is it an A? You're like, no. Is it a B? No. Is it a lizard? No. Is it a C? No. And they're going to go through all 26 letters until you finally get to where you have to go. And you're like, oh, you got it. You got a Z. You're so smart. So that's what the successive approximation register is. It's basically walking through all possible combinations there. And it's starting at the MSB first. Okay. So think about what's going on here. I've got an input voltage being fed into, you guessed it, a comparator. And what we're going to do is our successive approximation register is going to start at the MSB, okay, and it's going to say 1. All the other ones are 0. So what is the input to my digital to analog converter? It's 1, 0, 0. And it's going to ask the question, yo, is it an 8? And it's going to have that 8 volts being fed back in there. And that comparator is going to say, yes, it's greater than 8 volts, or no, it's not. Let's say, for example, no, it's not. It's not greater than 8 volts. So that 0, where is that 0 being fed into? Well, it's being fed into that successive approximation register. And because it's currently in this MSB condition, what's it do? It resets it to that 0. And now it goes on to the next one. Hey, is it a 4? And it asks the question. Hey, is it a 4? And let's go ahead and actually put an example on here. Let's say it's 6.2 volts. So is it a 4? Is it greater than a 4? And it's going to say, yes, it's greater than a 4. So substantially more intelligent than the four-year-old that's constantly guessing through all these things, it's going to bracket there. Okay, so now it's a 4. I know it's greater than a 4. Is it greater than a... Because again, what we're doing is here, we've solved that one. We're going to go on to this one. Is it now greater than a 6? And that DAC is going to go ahead and say, hey, is it greater than a 6? The answer is yes. 1 it is, so it keeps it. And then it walks down and it says, hey, is it greater than a, now we're in the LSP, is it greater than a 7? And the answer is no, it's not. It resets it. According to our very simplistic 1 volt levels there, 6.2 volts is equal to the digital output 6. And again, where are we getting the digital output from there? It's the same thing that's feeding that digital to analog conversion. And again, notice how many times I had to do that. I had to do it 4 times because there's 4 bit positions, hence the constant time it takes to go to do this. It's actually really easy to understand successive approximation. Let's go ahead, and because this is such a short lecture here, let's go ahead and put a different value on that. Let's just say 3.5 on voltage in. Let's see how this thing works. Okay, so we got 3.5 volts on our input there. Clock starts up and our successive approximation register starts at the MSB, 100. And our digital to analog converter is getting that digital data, 100. And it says 8 volts is its output. So is 3.5 greater than 8? The answer is no, it's not. So that bit position is reset. Now we move on to this next one here. Is it greater than a 4? And so 0100 is sent to our digital analog converter. What does that do? It produces a 4 volt signal. Is 3.5 greater than 4? The answer is no, it's not. So it's reset. Moves on to the next one and enables this bit right here and says, okay, is it greater than 0010, which is 2 volts? And the answer is yes, it is. So that one is kept. Moves on to the LSB position. Is it greater than 0011, the digital analog converter? Outputs 3 volts and 3.5. Is it greater than 3? The answer is 1. Yes, it is. Okay, keep that last value. Again, it took 4 renditions to walk through every single one of those positions from MSB down to LSB. And what we generated was 0011, a 4-bit approximation of 3 volts in that scale from 8 volts down to 0, 7 volts down to 0. That is a pretty quick and easy description of successive approximation, one of our numerous analog to digital conversion methods.